Hey guys, so today I wanted to share with you my empties. I have accumulated so much stuff over the past, I feel like this has been like a legit, like a year of just trash hanging out. Definitely gonna have to stay more on top of these. I feel like I say this in every single empties video. By the way, I will link all my empties below. I have quite a few at this point. This little bin and I, we have a full-on relationship now, okay? So I'm gonna just basically get on through them, okay? We have a trash bag. We are prepared for the empties, okay? I've never had the trash bag before. I feel like this is a genius idea, but we're gonna see, like, instead of me, like, throwing things across the room, if I can actually, like, keep it under control this time. So the first thing, and like I said, I'm gonna be really fast about this because there's a lot of crap, okay? So the first thing is the body butter in Mango by The Body Shop. Absolutely love it. I kind of got sick of the scent, not gonna lie, but I love this body butter. It's actually the first body butter that was ever created. Fun fact. The next few things are body creams, by Bath & Body Works. This is no surprise. Every freaking empties video, there's a sweet cinnamon pumpkin. Like, it wouldn't be my empties if there wasn't a sweet cinnamon pumpkin lotion in it. JK, the body cream, don't like the lotion, only the body cream. The lotion's not paraben free. Fun fact number two. Okay, so the second one is the Sweet Lemon Butter Cup. Love the scent. I don't know if that one's limited edition or not, but I do love that. Next thing is the Coconut Lime Breeze Shower Gel by Bath & Body Works. I don't know, like I like the scent, but then I just get sick of it and then I have to put it away, but I do like it. The next thing is the Ulta Beauty Sweet Grapefruit Moisturizing Body Lotion. It has shea butter, aloe, vitamins A, B, 5, C, and E in it. I love this stuff, okay? Like, I don't know, it's paraben free. At least I'm pretty sure it's paraben free. Yeah, not tested on animals, free from parabens, gluten, DEA, TEA, all that crap, and it, like, it's one of my favorite body moisturizers. Like, I just love it, and I love the scent, so I think I have a few of these in there. The next thing is a Clinique Clarifying Lotion in number 2. It's for dry combinations, 13 ounce. This took me from March of 2016 until now. It is September 2017 to finish. So this thing was worth it and I love it. I actually switched to the clarifying one though for acne because I've just been breaking out a lot and it has salicylic acid in it and this one didn't. So I did repurchase this just in a different form. Oh my god, I am so out of routine. Am I repurchasing things or not? Sweet cinnamon pumpkin and body butters, yes. Body Shop, eh, I might. And the Ulta body lotion, yes. Two brush cleansers, one's by Beauty So Clean and the other one is by Cinema Secrets. I like both of them, they do the job. This one smells delicious, it smells like cake pop. I got this forever ago, like when I went to IMATS, and it took me a while to use up, but I have the full size too. And then this one's not even used up all the way. I'll probably keep the bottle because I have the big size of Cinema Secrets and keep it in my kit, but this one does an awesome job too. So highly recommend both of these. The next thing is the Sun Bum SPF 50 gluten-free and vegan premium moisturizing sunscreen spray. Absolutely love this stuff. Yes, I am half black, but yes, I wear sunscreen all the time, especially in the summertime. So I wear SPF 50. My only complaint about this is that you go through it really fast since it is a spray, but that's all sprays for SPF. Next thing is Honest Beauty Truly Restored Recovery Mask. This stuff is the bomb. It is only like 30 bucks for this huge size. It's 6.7 fluid ounces. Definitely would repurchase this. It's paraben free, doesn't have any added fragrance, none of that junk, pretty natural, and it is amazing. Like, I just love this whole entire line, but this hair mask in particular works really well on my weave hair, but my real hair as well. So highly recommend this, especially if you have dry hair. It'll be great for winter time. We have another Ultra Shea Body Moisturizer. This is in Fiji Palm. We have quite a few Wish products. So Wish is an all-natural brand. They were on clearance at Ulta, and I was just like a crazy hoarder and bought like all of them from like multiple locations. Don't judge me, but they were like legit $3, but they retail for like $30. So I was like, what? Give me all of them. Okay, so with that being said, I would repurchase it obviously, but it's Wish. This one's the body butter and almond. Absolutely love this scent. It smells so freaking good, like a baked good, literally. This is the body butter in coconut. Love it. Body butter in pomegranate. Love it. This is the body oil in pomegranate. I really like this one for massages or when I went to the beach for the summertime. This is the Bath & Body Gel in almond. Again, I absolutely love this scent, but it's definitely a fall scent. So I'd only use the almond during the fall time. And then this is a shave cream in almond as well. I have some Eucerin products. Clearly, I repurchased this. This was a clearance product. I think I picked this up from Ulta as well. It was $13 originally, down to $3.24, so I just bought them all because I was like, whatever. If I don't like it, then I'll just go through it. But I loved it, and I'm like kind of sad because I'm like, well, where am I going to find it now? Because it obviously was clearanced out. But that's the nature of the beast, right? So it's the in-shower body moisturizer for dry skin, and it was fragrance-free. It's by Eucerin, so it's all dermatologist-tested. Absolutely love these. If you can find those, pick them up, because they are bomb. A few more body creams. Cetaphil moisturizing cream, great for just sensitive skin, great basic heavy moisturizer. I usually tend to gravitate towards this during the wintertime. Already repurchased another one, and by repurchase, I mean my mom always buys them at Costco for me, and she drops them off to me, because she loves me. So highly recommend. The next thing is the Palmer's Cocoa Butter formula. Years and years and years I've used this stuff, and I gravitated towards it every single time when I like can't decide what kind of body cream to get. But it smells like straight up cocoa, and it softens, and it has a pump, and I love this stuff. So I would definitely recommend it. Here's a cocoa butter that I wasn't a really big fan of. Definitely not as good as the Palmer's. It's the Nivea Cocoa Butter Body Lotion. There's actually a little bit in there still. But I was just trying to use this up. Like, I don't even know. It didn't dry down very well, and it was kind of sticky. I hated this stuff, so I don't like that. Okay, I think this is it for the body stuff. I used up the Tutti Dolce Sweet Lemon Buttercup Shower Gel. I already have another one. It's in my shower already. Love that scent. And then I used up the Philosophy Fresh Cream and Mint. I love the scent Fresh Cream. I don't think I would rebuy this, though. I liked it, but I got really sick of it, so. And although I love the formula, and I actually have the vanilla bean one in my shower right now as an option, like I have that one in my shower year round, I love it. This one, I just like found myself wanting to use up, so I don't think I would repurchase that again. Okay guys, it must have been like all body care. So let's dive into some hair stuff. It's a 10, Miracle Leave-In Light. Absolutely love this stuff. I actually really like the light formula better, just because it doesn't weigh the hair down. So I highly recommend that. This is by far my favorite freaking hair mask of all time, okay? Like, this needs a moment of silence. This one. I have like two more tubs of this because, again, it was on clearance, and it's, you can still get it, but it's like a smaller packaging for the same price as this one. So I was like, you're not tricking me, Wella. So I went ahead and stocked up, but it's the Elements Wella Professionals Reconstructing Mask. It's paraben-free. This stuff, I've never had my hair feel like more amazing. And by my hair, I mean like my natural hair and my weave hair. So it doesn't matter which kind of hair, this stuff is the bomb. Like I just can't stop raving about this. Like every single time somebody asks for about a hair mask, I recommend this one, always. A few more It's a 10 products. Here is the original It's a 10. I like it, but again, I like the light formula better. And then this hair mask was good. I like the Wella or the Honest Beauty one a lot better though. Like it was okay. It like didn't wow me like the other two. I used up an Honest Beauty Beyond Hydrated Shampoo. I really like this stuff too. I have this in my shower right now. It's just, again, doesn't have any junk in it, and it doesn't have any added fragrance, which I really appreciate it, but it also doesn't set up like an excessive amount, yet your hair feels clean and moisturized and soft afterwards. So I highly recommend the Honest Beauty hairline. Hands down, my favorite hair care line that has launched in the past few years. Like, I'm obsessed with the Honest Beauty hair care line. So, and then the last hair thing is the Orlando Pita Play Climate Change Humidity Blocking Hairspray. I really like this stuff. I rarely tend to buy hairspray because I usually like have a million and one like backed up for using, but I really like this and I highly recommend it. I even used this in Florida when humidity actually was an issue, and it worked really well. The next few things I'll show are skincare. Again, with Honest Beauty, highly recommend this stuff. I love this. I love, love, love this cleanser. Like, it's one of my favorites, actually. It's the Refreshingly Clean Gel Cleanser. It has yucca root extract and something I can't even pronounce, girl, so I'm not even gonna try. And then chamomile and calendula to help soothe and calm. I love this stuff. I felt like it really balanced out my skin, didn't strip it of oils, and it foams beautifully as well. And then, just like my last empties, I'm obsessed with these wipes. Like, hands down, my newest favorite makeup wipes of all time. You can find these, I believe, they pulled out of Ulta, but you can find them at Target now. So, still really easily accessible, and you can get them at your local Target, girl. Next thing is the Pure Skin Face Cleanser by First Aid Beauty. I don't know, I love the First Aid Beauty cream, not a fan of the cleanser. I don't know, I just felt like it didn't like leave my skin super clean. I didn't feel like any type of way about it. It just didn't wow me. You know, if I had another one, then I would use it, but it's not like something I would buy. Does that make sense? This is the Time in a Bottle by Philosophy. I love this. It's a vitamin C serum. Only complaint is that after, I believe it's 2 months, 3 months. 2 months, it doesn't say. It doesn't say this on here, but it says it on the bottle. Wait a second. I'm gonna find this. 3 months. After 3 months, once you pour the cap, which is active vitamin C, I believe, once you pour it in there, it will not work as well after 3 months, which makes sense. So be mindful of that. Another thing by Honest Beauty is the Younger Face Deep Hydration Cream. I really like this. I felt like it was almost too heavy though, so I tend to get a little oily throughout the day, so if you have really dry skin though, you will love this. This is the 5-in-1 Bouncy Mask by First Aid Beauty. It was okay. I don't think I'd buy it though. Like, it didn't wow me, you know? Again, but it's really hard to compare because that Ultra Repair Cream by that First Aid Beauty line is like amazing. So everything I'm expecting by First Aid Beauty to be equally amazing, but this one just didn't wow me, but it was good. Next thing is a special cleansing gel by Dermalogica. I love this cleansing gel, very similar to the Honest Beauty one, but I believe I used this on a trip and I really, really liked it. Lancôme High Resolution, Skincare moisturizer. It's SPF 15, triple action renewal. I'm not sure if this is getting discontinued or not, but I really like this. It's a good basic anti-aging moisturizer. Finally used up my Estee Lauder Revitalizing Supreme Global Anti-Aging Eye Balm. I got sick of this. So I know that it works like Estee Lauder, but Estee Lauder stuff is so concentrated that I don't know. I just want to use things up. Like, is there something just gratifying about using it up? So this took me like 2 years to finish, okay? But that's also because I've been like bouncing around with other eye creams. So I probably could have used it up in a good amount of time, or in a shorter amount of time if I like stuck to it, but I didn't, obviously. But I do love it. It's very hydrating under the eye and not too greasy. Last but not least for skincare is the Kate Somerville Eradicate. I went to go use this the other day and it dried up on me. So I actually just recently bought the Mario Badescu one because it's a lot cheaper. But I absolutely love this stuff. This was like holy grail status. Pretty sure they're the exact same thing. I mean, I'll let you know if the Mario Badescu one doesn't work as well, but I love, love, love this stuff. I used up a fragrance, Marc Jacobs Daisy, one of my all-time favorites. And I already have another one back there. I don't know if you can see it, it's right there. I used up a Pure Miracle Mist. I love this stuff. This is not your typical hydrating mist. It definitely is a makeup setting spray, but it also has botanicals and fruit extracts, which help your actual skin. It's a good skincare product on top of being a makeup setting spray. Photo Finish Primer Water. I'm not crazy about this. I don't know why everyone loved it so much. I'm not on the bandwagon. I'm not gonna rebuy this. Okay, so I used up 3 mascaras, 2 of them being They're Real. This one's just the Swarovski Crystal like edition, and then the regular They're Real. I love this one. This is like ride or die. Like I always go back to it. And then I love the Urban Decay Perversion mascara only on my false lashes. I feel like it's not enough on its own, but on my false lashes, it just does wonders for like, you know, putting them on. Like this will clump my false lashes up. This one will just kind of glide them on up. You know what I mean? Make them look a little bit natural. JK, there's one more mascara. This is the Sumptuous Extreme by Estee Lauder. This is my favorite Estee Lauder mascara. I love the wand. I see a common theme here. I really love Honest Beauty stuff. So this is the Magic Balm. I already have 2 more of these. I use this up completely. It is 100% organic. You can use it. I use it around my cuticles, but I also use it on my lips before I go to bed too. So I have this right by my nightstand already. I used up an Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. I absolutely love this stuff, already repurchased. I used up a Gimme Brow in like the OG packaging. Absolutely love this, already have it. But I did change from a color 5 to a color 3 because the color 3 is warmer and I feel like I have more warmer undertones. I used up a Goof Proof pencil in the color 4. Absolutely love this thing. I love the formula. It just glides on smooth and it is waterproof, which I appreciate. The Brow Definer by Anastasia is not as waterproof, at least as I feel like, as the Goof Proof. I used up 2 liquid eyeliners. This is the Too Faced one. The packaging kind of has worn off. And then the Stilist Day All Day. This is my holy grail, the Stilist Day All Day, but I love this one. This was on a hot buy, or not a hot buy, the Beauty Steal or whatever it's called for Ulta 21 Days of Beauty, and I purchased 2 of them. Like, I'm obsessed with this one. I find that it goes on a little bit more precise than the Stilist Day All Day, but Stilist Day All Day is my holy grail because I know that it'll like be my ride or die. You know what I mean? So I love them both. I use up 2 eyeshadow primers, the Too Faced Shadow Insurance, and then the Anti-Aging Urban Decay one. I prefer the Urban Decay one. I don't know really why. They kind of work the same. I mean, I don't know why I prefer the Urban Decay one. Just this one has extra peptides in it to help your eye area, but I don't know. I just feel like this one works a little bit better, and maybe I'm just biased because I always love the Urban Decay one, but Too Faced, like, is a close second. Like, they're basically the same thing. And I use a MAC Paint Pot, like, on top of it anyway because I have super oily lids. So I don't even know why I have a preference of either of them. Both of them are good. Both of them are good. I used up a Clarisonic brush head, obviously. I'm going to repurchase this. This is the normal one. I actually prefer normal as opposed to the deep pore or the acne. I used up a MAC Paint Pot and Lay and Low. It dried out on me, but I already have another one. I love this stuff. That's my like everyday primer. Oh, look, here's the Smashbox 24-hour primer. I use this as well. I do like this one. If I use this on its own, I don't need to necessarily put on the MAC Paint Pot, but I think I just do that because I'm used to it, you know? I'm like, might as well. And then I used up the Smashbox Photo Finish Dark Spot Correcting Primer. I feel like they discontinued this one, but I absolutely loved it. Like, it wasn't that heavy, like, dimethicone feeling, like their original one. It's more like their light formula, but it was dark spot correcting, and anything dark spot correcting, I'm a fan of, so love that. I used up, oh, one more body product, the Tea Tree Oil Cooling Foot Scrub. Already repurchased. This is $2, and this, like, takes me 6 months or so to use up one of them, so I just buy the smaller version. I used up a Tarte Shape Tape in the color medium. I already have 2 backups of this. This is my absolute favorite under eye concealer. I'm obsessed with it. I'm sure you've heard it forever, ever, and ever. Amen. They better never stop making that, I swear. I used up, and by used up, I'm gonna throw this away, is my Transparent Lucidity Pressed Powder. I might try to save this because this is one of my favorite pressed powders by Estee Lauder, but they discontinued it. So I already bought another one because I found it at a CCO, and it was like sheer luck. It was like the last one, but I'm really sad that they discontinued this. So I might try to save that now that I think about it. It's a little extra effort, but worth it, right? Last but not least, I used up a Hoola bronzer. So satisfying. Like, look at all that pan. Woo woo. All of that gone. Like, the packaging is turned up. Like, it is done. So that is it. So tell me in the comments below, if you're still watching this video, any of the products I've tried, what your opinions are, and I'm gonna go clean up this mess. I don't know why I thought it was a good idea to have a trash bag, because clearly that didn't happen. Let me show you the results real quick. The aftermath of empties right here. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and thumbs it up and don't forget to hit subscribe. And then I'll link all of my previous empty videos in the description bar so you can go ahead and look at all the other previous stuff that I've used up. So anyway, I hope you have a fabulous day and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.